way you're supposed to do it, Dad. They want us to do it this way.
I don't know that way. Why would they change math? No, math is math. Okay, math, Dad. Is math.
That's not the way you're supposed to do it.
Parents, we know you can relate to this one. Greg says that's him. The way schools teach math is a lot different these days. So our live poll is still open right now. Tell us which method you think is best, new school or old school.
Yeah, we're presuming many of you who are parents kind of have been introduced to this new school method via your kids. So this is how we solve this problem. Are we ready for this, Tiffany?
This is how I solve the problem.
So 43 minus 18. Remember when you used to cross out the 4, change it to a 3, then carry the 1? Now you have to subtract 8 from 13 to get the 5. This is all reverse here. And then the 3 minus the 1 is 2. Comes a new way of doing this, folks.
This is how I solve the problem.
We're turning on its head everything you knew. And that's how Sonia solves it. She goes straight for the phone and the calculator. Let's get over to Hannah Davis.
You tell us how to do
it. She's still being learned on this method.
I'm being learned. I actually learned this yesterday, guys, so this could be a little rough this morning.
Well, it went smoothly at 5.
Yeah, the bar's not very high at 6:30. We had some technical difficulties, but that's neither here nor there. Okay, so I'm going to talk to you about this new method. We call it new school, but teachers say it's actually conceptual-based. That's what they like to call it. Before I show you that, I want to show you what parents were saying yesterday. I did a Facebook Live asking them, how frustrated do you get when you do math homework with your child? 200 comments later, it was clear parents get frustrated. Take a look at this comment right here. Rhonda says, it's hard to even explain. They have to break it all down. I don't get it. It's frustrating. And then I loved Kelly's comment. She said, 5 kids here. Kids 1 and 2 were taught different than the rest, and I gave up after kid 1. So maybe that's the solution to everything. But let's get to this new school method, and I'm going to show you guys how I learned to do this yesterday. So bear with me. I'm new at this. Basically, what they want to do is they want to teach children the concept of what these numbers are. So they break it down into units. 43 here is 4 groups of 10. So they do that like that. Then you have 3 over here. 18, that is 1 group of 10. And then you have the 8 over here. Let's see if I can remember this. Now you drop this down. 40 minus 10 is 30. You can't do 3 minus 8. So now you have to come down, borrow from 30. Make that 20, bear with me, bring the 10 up here. We've got 13, 13 minus 8 is 5.
Hannah, that's 7 more steps.
Hold on, let me take a breath. 20 plus 5 equals 25.
That
so 8,000 steps later, we get to the answer. Now, I know this takes longer. I know it can seem confusing for people that learned it a different way like myself, but I talked to teachers and they said the whole concept here is to get children to understand math and then they can memorize moving forward. Here's what one of those teachers from Frisco ISD said. She explained it to me yesterday.
Our standards did shift to more of a flexible strategy thinking with students, and so our teaching practices have shifted too. Kids do eventually get to the algorithm where we learned it back in the day of in school, but we want them to have that deep understanding.
So again, I know parents are frustrated, but there's good news. There are resources for you so you can understand this new way. Frisco ISD actually put up this whole deal explaining how to do it, like a how-to for parents, and also the rationale behind it. I'm going to put this link on our website. I know a lot of the parents I talked to yesterday, I think Mr. Fields also.
Mr. Fields is not enjoying it.
It makes absolutely no sense to me.
Show your work? Like the kids have to show all that?
Yes, that's the issue.
Point.
Parents want to show you the quick way. They want you to show your work, and parents say, I don't know how to do it.
Right there.
No, I think it's easier in your head to break the 8 and the 10 into a 10 and an 8, take 10 away from 43,
well,
33
minutes. 94% of people agree with you. Old school wins.
Old school.
Old school's winning.
That's because we're not adaptable people.
We don't like change.
You know
like
why
change.
That is? That's because the kids doing the new school math
Don't
watch the TV in the morning.